Hi everyone, Chef from Outdoors in the Low Countries, and in this video I want to show you the creation of the device that I made myself. I intend to use it for taking out stumps from trees that I saw down, or sometimes when you mill over a bush, then also those little stumps they still are in the ground, and then when you use a chain harrow or a mower then you are hooked by them. So that's something I don't like. You have to take them out using a spade or an axe, and an axe, something like that. But I thought, hey, why not use a root ripper? I know the root rippers, you can buy them for with a Euro coupling for drag lines, things like that. But I haven't seen them for the front loader. So what I now did is I created one myself. I use some old material, 15 millimeter thick, from the scrapyard. I saw it lying there, so I bought it. And I also bought online an interface welding plate and combined it all together using the plasma cutter and welding it onto it, and that way I created this device. Now it looks a little bit like a horn of a rhino, so I call it the Rhino Root Ripper. And in this video I will show you how I created it.
So I was in the scrapyard not so very long time ago, where they sell all types of materials that they take from old houses and old buildings that they tear down. And I saw these very thick steel plates. They're galvanized. They are 15 millimeter thick. And I saw a bunch of them. And I thought, hey, this is interesting, because this is something I can make some nice things off for on the front loader. So that's what I'm planning to do, to make some nice things that I can attach to the front loader. And put this aside. And I already made the first draw. So here you can see that I made already a first drawing on how I want to make this ripper. And I want to make it to put it on the front loader in order to able to cut off the roots of a stump that is standing somewhere that I want to remove. I tried to look for that on the internet to see if they are being sold anywhere on a Kubota front loader or a Bobcat plate, interface plate, but I couldn't find any, so I think I have to make it myself, so I will do that. And that's also why I was very interested in this thick steel plates, because you really have to have some strength, of course, to prevent that it's going to be bent when you put it under a root or into the ground. And when you hit something, you don't want to have it bent quite easy. So let's make it. The first step is that I will take the form out with the plasma cutter and then weld it to the to a plate to be able to put it onto the front loader. So you can see here I already made the first idea of what it should look like. So here's the ripper now. With the grinder I put in the teeth, and I also cleaned up a little bit the rest. The shape is not that very accurate, but it's good to clean it up a little bit, not to have sharp edges which you can cut your hand. But so now the next step is to weld it onto a base plate. And the base plate that I can attach towards the front loader of the Kubota. In order to create some strength to the construction, I will use these triangles to stiffen and strengthen the part. I tried them first in wood, and I draw them here on these remainder parts, as you can see, and I will cut them out and then weld them to the ripper to create strength. So here is the Rhino Ripper stump remover. It's important to have visibility on this Rhino Ripper, and because it's at the front side of the Kubota and the welding plate is in between, I don't know what the visibility needs to be in order to have it proper functioning. So to test that up front before I do all the weldings and before I do all the cutting in the welding plate, I made this wooden mucker. Now this wooden mock-up has about the size of the welding plate, and as you can see, also there's the shape of the stump removal in it. It's about the same size, so it's already quite good for testing. So now what I will do is I will make some holes to see what the visibility is, and then if it's doable, let's say, to then have the stump removal. What is important is that while during operation, the roots will be on top of the ripper, let's say at this point. So when you move it up to remove the roots, the ripper will be bent down, and as a result there will be a torque coming into this plate. When you now have a complete hole at this side, in order to have good visibility, you also make a very weak construction, because there will be really bending torque exactly at this point. So it would be good if I could have a stiff construction here to prevent bending of this plate, but that will also reduce my visibility. So what I now will do is I will make first two holes here, there's a construction in between, which I can even increase the strength by having a stiffener on the backside, and having those two visibility holes to see if that's good enough to work with. The other possibility is to have a complete hole, but then it becomes a little bit weak, so that's I want to avoid that. So this is the mock-up of my ripper, the visibility holes, and let's see how well they perform, how well the visibility is putting it on the Kubota. So I now put it on with some clamps, as you can see, some glue clamps. And this is the view from behind the steering wheel, and you can see that you have to move aside a little bit and then it becomes visible. Now that's quite okay, and also that it's better to have it a little bit more deeper, because you have to go up a little bit in order to see the ripper. So it's best to go a little bit deeper than I did now. So that's some attention points for making the real one.
Parts we're going to use are galvanized. That means there's a small layer of zinc on top of it. And the parts where I need to weld it, I need to clean the zinc off, because it doesn't weld very well with the zinc still on it. So I will clean it. It's not very healthy to inhale the vapor that is coming from this cleaning. So I'll wear a mask and I will do it outside to prevent the vapor inside my workshop. In order
mount this root ripper to the front side of the front loader, I will use this interface plate. This interface plate, it's a Bobcat interface welding plate. It's 6 mm thickness. At the top side, there's even 12 mm to make it extra strong, extra stiff. As you can see, it also has an extra plate over here to make it strong, to make this 12 mm extra strong. At the back side, we put in an extra plate to have the interface strong. So I think it's a very good interface plate. The weldings at the top side have only been done very limited, so you can still remove things if you want to. But it's which I want, by the way, because I really like this the stiffness. What I could do is I could directly weld the root ripper onto this plate. It's 6 mm, so it's quite strong. Nevertheless, I decided to have an interface plate for that. This is 12 mm thick steel. I use this to reduce the peak load onto this plate, because there can be quite some bending on it when the ripper is underneath some root, and in order to prevent that, to divide the stress onto the interface, I decided to use an extra interface plate, which I will do, which I will weld onto the Bobcat interface plate. Another advantage is that by having this, I can have the root ripper a little bit downwards, and then the ripper is then going to be mounted on top of the interface plate. These holes have been cut out in order to have a good view on the ripper, and I used a wooden mock-up to see how important they were, and they really are, because otherwise you can't really see where the ripper is at. But it also weakens the construction, and when the ripper is underneath a root or something else, another object, and you want to move up the front loader, there will be a bending moment onto the ripper. And the bending moment will come in the construction at this location. And in order to have bending of this plate, to have deformation, which is quite thick, it's 6 millimeters, but nevertheless, to have it a little bit more strong, I added this beam, and now there's quite a strong construction against any bending from the ripper, and it will conduct well towards the top part and the front part where the two interfaces are with the front loader. So this makes the construction much stronger, which helps. And even though with 6 millimeter steel, bending in a plate is not strong, and this helps enormously to have a much stronger construction. Now the blade of the ripper is galvanized, so it's covered with zinc. So the first thing I will do is I will use a primer, a non-ferro primer, in order to create the first layer, the first primer layer of the blade of the ripper. So in the video on the cover plate of the hydraulics of the front loader, I tried RAL 2008 as a orange color for the Kubota, and it was clearly not a very good fit. So this time I did a little bit different. I took a part with me that had a quite good color match to the hardware store, and they have this very small measurement device. They put it on, and then I can actually measure what type of color it is. So I now have other paint with the color that was measured. I'm going to put it on the ripper, and let's see how well it fits this time. See that it's now going to be much more a Kubota implement instead of some device from the A-Team or from Mad Max. It's already getting quite a nice color, and also the color match is not that bad, so it's good. So why this design? By having this curved shape of the ripper, you can really go into the ground, and by curling back the front loader, you are really diving underneath the root. And then you can go back and then take out the root, maybe moving the front loader a little bit up. When you have really thick roots, you can also use those sharp points in order to already saw some of the thick roots out, but also it will help to really catch the root by pulling it back. So let's try it.